Kweli alikuwa wangu lakini sasa sinae. Kweli alikuwa wangu lakini sasa sinae. Aliwezi pendo langu nimeshaachana naye. Aliwezi pendo langu nimeshaachana naye. Bora niwe peke yangu yamenishinda mambo ye. Bora niwe peke yangu yamenishinda mambo ye. Yasini mkatae.
$500, eh? They have to divide. So you need that for kiddo. Like I know.
Okay.
Yes.
Another problem that I may be having. I thought that the clips and the videos, the museum was going to help us with that.
Yes. At one point we shall see what kind of logistical support to give you, and that will come in tomorrow's discussions. Yeah.
Thank you.
With the groups. The youth groups, eh? Tulisema ikiwa wana members ambao wana fit that criteria, then the others will help them to produce this content. But ultimately, ambao tunapeleka kule has to fit in that age group. So if it is your group, then you will support whoever fits or you want to be featured. Mutamsaidia sasa yeye kutengeza hiyo kitu na kupresent.
Just contribute to what that is. I'll spend only 2 minutes with this photo before I start my presentation. What is the color of that object? Very quickly. What is the color? Can I drop your hand and tell me? What is the color of that object? Come on. What is the color of that object? Yes? Stand up. Brown, okay. How many parts does that object have? Just raise up your hand quickly, please. Yes, please.
Four
parts. Okay. Where do you think it was made? Where was it made? Just give it a try. Where do you think it was made? You don't have to be right. Where do you think this thing was made? Yes, please. In Lamu. Okay, anybody else? Yes?
Made in Kenya.
Why do you say Lamu?
Lamu, it's originated from England, it's from Bombay.
So it was made in Lamu?
Yeah.
Okay. You say?
It is made in Kenya.
In Kenya. Why? What makes you say it was made in Kenya? Okay. What materials have been used to make these objects? What materials have been used? Quickly. What materials have been used here? Yes?
Wood.
Wood. Any other material?
Iron.
Iron. Very good. Okay. Yes, please.
Metal.
Metal. Very good. Okay. What shapes can you see in these objects? Different types of shapes that you can see. Huh?
Square.
Square.
Circle.
Okay. Yes?
Semicircle.
Semicircle. Very good. Now, who do you think made these objects? Who do you think made these objects? Yes? Yes?
The Portuguese.
The Portuguese? Uh-huh. Good. Anybody else? Who do you think made these objects? Yes?
The Swahilis.
The Swahilis. Huh? Now, what do you think this object is used for? What is the purpose of this object? What do you think this object is used for? Yes?
For cutting chips.
For?
Cutting chips.
Pardon?
Cutting chips.
Cutting?
Chips.
Chips. Chips. Chips. Uh-huh. Yes? Making curry, Yes, give it a try.
Macaroni.
Macaroni, So, thank you so much for your answer. Basically, what I'm trying to illustrate, is that photos of objects tell us stories about those objects. So you can basically generate a lot of ideas and a lot of stories by just taking one good photo. Is that clear? Yeah. So that is the power of photography as a means of communication. That is the power of photography as a means of
communication.
You don't really need to have that object in your hand. You don't really need to be where that object or that person is. But the mere fact that you have a photo of an object or a thing, then you can learn so much about that. That's what we have. So my interest today is basically to share with you photographs as communication tools. Photographs as communication tools.
About 10 minutes. It's something inspirational. I was just watching it yesterday. It is very educational. Kwa hivyo ningependa tusikize sote, kisha will make a comment.
Watoto ambao miaka itakayokuja, usi itakayokuja, mtaweza kuendeleza zaidi. Wingi ukiangalia wale wenye kutengeneza video, nafikiri kinamjua gharama na zaidi na
malaki.
Malaki, sio? Mmekuwa mkifanya mkiiga video nyingi, lakini ile kutengeneza zile video siwe kama za Hollywood na Bollywood. Ili Kenya nawe iweze kutambulikana, inatoa si watu wenye kuenda kwenye sinema, lakini watu wenye kuenda sinema. Haikuanza kwa siku moja, ilichukua muda. na tungependelea ifike sababu nyinyi wenyewe mnajivunia mnapiga video wenyewe kuna afanya acting wenyewe na kila kitu ili iendeleze biashara za rafu. Sitaki kuzungumza zaidi kwa sababu ya wakati. Ningetaka kuchukua nafasi at least ifanye introduction kwa wale wageni ambao wako na mimi. Nafikiri kuna mmoja mdogo lakini yeye kwa sababu pia yeye tumemlokesha hatukutaka kukosa hii nafasi mjuane na hao aliyoko kwa upande wangu wa kulia ni Emmanuel Jambo.
Started just this is a humble photographer out of Atlanta and worked my way up. I came here, I started my production company and started working with the president. We worked with a lot of members of parliament, ministers. We work with a lot of artists, top artists in East Africa. We do photography, we do videography, we got nominated by different countries. So yeah, so that's basically what we've been doing and we're here to support you guys. I know the past, probably maybe 5 years, tourism in the country has been at the lowest point, and especially Lamu, which is, in my personal opinion, is one of my favorite spots. So it's been suffering due to a lot of insecurity and politics maybe. But we're here to bring that picture back, to bring the image of Lamu. You know, the rich history, the we just helping each other. Yeah. So if you guys have any questions, you could ask.
Swali. Since you start till now, how many years?
Huh?
Since you start till now, how many years?
La 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 la.